Alright. Now I'm gonna play through this whole motherfucking game. Everybody's favorite Mega Man game, Mega Man 2. And I'll show you how easy this game is. At least to me. It's probably the only game series I'm really that good at. I mean, I could beat a game, but who can't beat a game? So, Mega Man, I fucking beast it. So, I'm gonna beast this game, and you're gonna watch it, and I'm gonna kinda ramble on for however long this takes me. This won't take too long, though. Now, if you don't know the story of Mega Man, he's the blue guy with no helmet. Fucking android. So, the first game, you have Dr. Light, Dr. Wily, and there are a couple of scientists, you know, doing their thing. And, Dr. Wily is jealous of Dr. Light, because, well, everybody thinks Wily is like a creepy, fucking, evil, dirty guy. And, Light takes all the credit because he's a genuine genius and total boss. So, he wants his revenge by taking all of his big robots, which were the original six robots in Mega Man 1, which I'm not going to play because that game kind of sucks. Fucking archaic and stupid compared to this game. Mega Man 1, you had like all these bosses that were like practical robots built by Dr. Light to help the world. And so he said, fuck it, I'm going to reprogram them and make them kill people. And so Dr. Light took his scientist assistant named Rock and said, hey, we're going to make you to a fighting robot. We're going to give you a gun, and hopefully you don't kill people like all the other robots with guns do. So that's how Mega Man was created. And then he killed all the robots and became the champ. And so now Mega Man 2, Wily is obviously... They tried to incarcerate him, but he got away. And now, now I have to deal with it and do it again. But this time, it's not the Dr. Light's robots. It's Dr. Wily's robots he built. And he's a good scientist, but his robots fucking suck. So, I'm gonna completely destroy them. So now, I died right there. That's the only intentional death I'm gonna have in this game. And hopefully the only death I'll have at all in this game, because it's not that hard. So, starting out with Metal Man, and the reason why I'm starting with Metal Man is because Metal Man is fucking completely overpowered with his weapon. His weapon destroys pretty much everything in the game in like one or two hits. Like, even bosses are like way easy with his weapon. It's completely ridiculous. I don't know if it was intentional, if they just didn't think it out properly, or what, but, the metal discs are just way too fucking powerful, so obviously I have to kill him first and take him. And he's not even challenging. He's just gonna stand there, hope he can hit me from across the room. Because, you know, you're not supposed to charge him, or this shit starts happening. And it gets a little more complicated, but let's see if I almost died like a boss. So now I'm gonna teleport out of here. Which this is before, like, this is why I like Mega Man 3 better. Mega Man 3 added so many things to this game that are kinda iconic now, and they weren't iconic then. Like, you just teleport out of there, and you have the new boss's weapon. But in every Mega Man after this one, you would absorb their life bubbles or something, because that's totally how robots work. So watch here. I'm basically gonna use this weapon for most of the rest of the game, because you get like a million shots, and there's, you know, there's constantly power-ups to, you know, recharge and everything, and, yeah, it fucking destroys everything way better and way faster than the regular blaster. Well, except for these guys. These guys, if I hit them with the fucking metal, then just their shell will fly off, and then I won't be able to hit their base. So, I'd rather just kill them in one pellet shot. So, I'm fighting Bubble Man, because Bubble Man is fucking easy as hell. What did I get? Oh, yeah. No, I don't get the gen. I don't remember what I get from this guy. I'm trying to remember what the items are. And, I don't think I get an item from this guy. I think I just get the bubbles. I needed bubbles to kill Heat Man. But I'm not gonna kill Heat Man first, because first I gotta get the jets. And to get the jet, I gotta kill Air Man. Now, at first, when I first played this game, this is like one of the hardest parts, like the most iconically hard parts for me. Because, you know, it's always hard when there's death, instant death spikes surrounding you. I mean, look at this. It's like fucking. He's shooting like 100 of them at once. What am I supposed to do? I don't know what's all up with that screen flickering, by the way. Something with the game and Fraps and doesn't want to cooperate, but whatever. I can still see everything. I can still understand what's going on. It's usually not like this, though. Just putting that out there. But this is one of the things that frustrates me, is Mega Man 2 still has, like, a holdover from Mega Man 1, where Mega Man 1 wasn't hard, or, well, it was hard, but the hardest thing about Mega Man 1 and Mega Man 2 is that enemies constantly respawn if they're, like, one or two pixels outside of your screen or something, you know? So, you kill an enemy and you just walk, like, two steps and it's back. Which, that don't happen in the other games, but there's a lot more leeway, you know? Now, it's the same with the metal. I killed him in, like, 4 shots. And that's not even his weakness. I don't even know what his fucking weakness is. Because you just use metal on half the bosses, and they die in, like, 3 shots, so what does it even matter? Which is another thing why I don't like this game. This isn't my favorite Mega Man. This is everyone's favorite Mega Man game. But this is totally not my favorite Mega Man game. And there's a lot of reasons for that. And one of them is that these bosses, while these bosses are kind of challenging for their time, because, like, they're really hard to dodge their hits, partly because they just fucking cover the screen, and partly because you can't slide. Like, you're still limited in mobility to just walking around. And then all the other Mega Mans after this, you can slide. Which, you know, you had to make the bosses way harder then, because you can now move really fast. So, the bosses aren't really that tricky, but you can't really dodge them. So, you're gonna get hit in the face a lot. Now, kill this guy with the blades, like I do everything, because it only takes 5 hits. Which is way less than it takes with pellets. Can't dodge them all. The first time I played this, I thought it was the hardest shit, because it was tough enough to kill one, and, you know, getting through and then finding a checkpoint. But, no, they make you kill 3 in a row, and there's no health ups or anything after that. Just good luck, fucker. But, you know, after some practice, you get it. Look at this, I mean, this should be, like, a tough enemy, the fucking monkeys and these birds. Especially the birds. The birds are, like, most frustrating enemy in this game, just because if they drop that egg, there's no way you're killing all that shit without getting hit once. It's just completely unpredictable. It's like a shotgun with homing technology. And these bunnies take exactly 3 hits. I mean, look at this. This whole game was fucking designed for this metal blade. You know? Even that, right there. Look at it. Everything is right in your path for the metal blade, but it's not in your path for the blaster. Now this is the part where you can't use the metal blade, because it bounces off these guys. So this is almost like, fuck, I timed that one wrong. Those ostriches are almost like the Medusa heads from Castlevania of Mega Man 2. Closest thing you're gonna get to them, I guess. So let's see. Kill this guy with the metal blades, which I think is actually his weakness. I don't remember. No, actually it's not. Apparently you'll see it later. You can kill him in 1 shot if you use the fireball. So, I guess that would be his weakness, but Metal Blade fucking kills everything, so why not use it? And that's why this game is kind of like you think it's hard, but it's not. In that, you know, I took like 2 hits from that guy, and I was almost dead. So, yeah. I mean,